Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making mint juleps. That is the drink of the Kentucky Derby, the official drink. So I haven't made one yet in Betty's Kitchen, so I thought I would treat you to that today. And actually it's a two-day process, or you can hurry it up a little bit. It doesn't make a lot of difference. But you start out by making a simple syrup, and that means I need a pot, and I want to put half sugar and half water, or equal parts sugar and water. And I've chosen 1/2 cup for sugar, and then that means 1/2 cup for water. Now mix these together. And in cold water, the sugar will not dissolve. I'm going to add some mint, and then we'll be taking this to the stove, boiling it for 5 minutes, and all of this will dissolve and it will have a mint flavor. Now I need about 5 leaves of mint. Here at the end are the most tender leaves, and this did live over the winter and had long shoots that came up. So I'm going to take call this 1 leaf, and then there's a second, third, fourth, and fifth. And that's plenty. And you can see what I'm taking to the stove. Now I want to bring this to a boil and boil it for 5 minutes. So I'll be stirring and tending occasionally. You don't have to really keep right on top of it, but just make sure that sugar is dissolved and you have your simple syrup. Then we'll go from there. This is what your simple syrup should look like after 5 minutes of boiling. You can see those mint leaves in there have infused some color and some flavor into our simple syrup. So I'm bringing this over to my workspace. And what I will do at this point is let this cool to a room temperature, and then I will put it in the refrigerator, and you should refrigerate it overnight before you mix up your drink. This is the base, which is the mint-flavored simple syrup, and you'll just use 1 tablespoon of this base for each one of your drinks. So it didn't make a whole lot. But I'll see you tomorrow, and we'll put the drink together. So here we are after letting our simple syrup with our mint leaves in it chill overnight. And see, it's kind of thickened a little bit. It's a little viscous. So what we're going to do is put together our mint julep. This is actually an old-fashioned glass. That old-fashioned is the kind of drink. So that's the kind of glass I'm going to use. Normally in Kentucky on Derby Day, the glass that is used is actually made of metal. It is a mint julep glass, and it is called a julep cup. I don't have one currently. I've had them in the past, but I decided just to use an old-fashioned glass. So we're going to start by putting in 1 tablespoon of our syrup that we have made overnight. Now, you'll make as much of this as you want, depending on how many of these you're going to put together. But Rick and I aren't going to need a lot, I tell you that. Now, I have removed some mint leaves from this stalk. You don't want to use the stalk part. You want to use the leaves, and I've got about 6 here. And it's just up to you. You can put as many as 12 in a single serving. Now, you want to crush these a little bit. They will actually bruise, but that's called muddling. And you want to muddle your mint in order to get some of the flavor out of it and into the drink. So now we're going to move over here and get some crushed ice. And you want this to be the last thing that you get out of your freezer before you put this together. And you want this dry. You don't want it all melted together. So you'll just take a spoon or something and put as much of the ice in as you want. And then we're ready for 2 ounces of Kentucky bourbon. Now you can use whatever brand you want. At the Kentucky Derby, they use a particular brand, but I normally use Maker's Mark for everything I do, so this happens to be Maker's Mark. And this little glass is a Maker's Mark shot glass, but it's a little overfull for a shot. So 2 ounces will go in there. So this is very intensely alcoholic. And then I've got a little straw right here and a little garnish. And since the garnish isn't coming to the top, I think what I will do is add more ice. And this actually probably needs to be watered down a little bit because it's very strong. And try to have a nice look for this. And there we go. There we have a nice mint julep for Derby Day. Hope you enjoy it. It is a necessity for a Derby party in Kentucky to serve mint juleps. And they are strong, but this is the recipe pretty much that is used at Churchill Downs where the Kentucky Derby is run. I'm going to taste this for you. You know, I normally don't do much tasting of the alcoholic items that I make. I'm not against it. It's just I tend not to do that. But here goes. Ooh, that is strong. But if you're a true Kentuckian, you'll have a mint julep on Derby Day. That's May the 5th.
Betty asked me to take a sip of this. I've already had a sip, a big sip. Just have another one. It's bourbon whiskey, all right. With a little sweetness and some mint. I don't think people really don't drink a lot of mint juleps except for Derby time, but as Betty said, it is a tradition. May the 5th this year, at least, is the Kentucky Derby. Maybe you'll be watching.
It's the first Saturday in May of every year.
Yep.
So it falls on May the 5th this year. So goodbye, everybody. I need to. We'll see you soon.
Bye.